Hello friends, now we'll study next part in PHP is functions. A function in PHP contains a small bit of code that accomplishes a task. Okay, what function do? Okay, a function do a small task. For example, maybe sum of two numbers or maybe a factorial of number like this. This function can maybe behave differently based on the values of the parameters. Okay, if you pass the parameter, it take that parameter and calculate it. Okay, you can pass the parameters or you cannot pass the parameter, it's optional. It exists all on its own and is called from anywhere that needs to make use of them. You need to call the function to do some particular task. You need to call the function. In PHP, there are two types of functions, user-defined functions and built-in functions. Okay, there are two types of functions. One is user-defined functions and another is built-in functions. A user-defined function is one that the programmer defined. Okay, user-defined function, is one that programmer defined. Okay, for example, some factorial, like this, can define by the user. A programmer. A built-in function is one of the function that come with the PHP environment. Okay, that built-in functions are defined by the PHP environments, means who designed the PHP software. Okay, that manufacturer. One of the real strengths of PHP is its rich library of built-in functions. There are many built-in functions are available in PHP. Function syntax. The PHP function uses function keyword followed by the function name. Okay, so in PHP we have to use function keyword. Okay, then the function name, then round brackets for parameters, and then the body of the function inside curly brackets. Okay, say for example, the syntax is what? Function name. First keyword is the keyword function, then function name, then in bracket parameter list, then curly brace open, then curly brace close. For example, function getSum. GetSum is the user defined function. Okay, you do some calculations here, then you close. Okay, here there are no parameters. Okay, you can pass the parameters. Okay, function can return values to the caller or not return a value. Okay, so sometime it returns, sometime not return a value. Okay, a function called getNiceTime, which will return a formatted string containing the current server time. Okay, getNiceTime, it returns what? Server time. Okay, this is the code. Function getNiceTime return date HIS. Return date HIS. See, we'll execute this one, it become very clear. Open XAMPP software. Open XAMPP control. Then start. Click start, then admin. Then give the file name, localhost file name, servertime.php. So it displays what? Server time. Okay, if you click again, it change the time. Okay, every time it change. Okay, or you can call the function getNiceTime. Okay, then it returns the value. Okay, then you can display. Okay, next, if the function does not return a value, you can just call this function getSum. Okay, see, there is a one more program, PHP program, to find the sum of 5 and 6. Okay, we'll execute this one. All the programs in htdocs folder. function.php. okay, so function.php file. okay, so here you pass argument 15 and 6. Okay, it jumps here, then x value is 15, y value is 6. It calculate 15 plus 5, then return z. okay, it contain the sum of two numbers, then it assign to sum, then display echo. Just save and execute. The file name is function.php. Okay, it displays what, 21. If we change the values, example, okay, make it 25 and 16. Okay, 25 plus 16, 41. Just save, refresh. So it displays 41. Okay. Next parameter. Okay, so here parameter is also passed here. Okay, next parameter default values. Okay, parameter default values. So here in PHP, parameter default values can be set for any parameter in a function. However, once you start having default values, all subsequent parameter must also have defaults. See here, just call the function. Okay, sum of 15 and 10, get sum. Okay, here it passed only 15 here. Okay, so what happened here is that x 15 is assigned to x. Okay, so y value is assigned 10 in function body only. Okay, so in bracket only, so it assigned here. Okay, so if you not pass second value, so it take this default value. Okay, if you pass 14, then it replace 10 to 14. Okay, so here in the first output, sum of 15 and 10, so 15 is passed here, 15 plus 10, 25. So in second output, sum of 12 and 14, 12 and 14 is passed. 12 assigned to x, 14 assigned to y. So 12 plus 14, 26. Okay, then second, third output, sum of 25 and 10, 25 assigned to x, 10 assigned to y here. Okay, so second y value is not passed here. Okay, y it take this value. Okay, so it displays what, 35. Okay, so it displays 35 here. Then here is one output, sum of 5 and 6 is 11. Okay, we'll execute this one. Okay, function 2, file name is function 2. So it displays sum of 5 and 6, 11. Okay, I just change the value, instead of 15, make it 25. 25 is already present, make it 35. So sum of 35 and 10, 45. Okay, 35 and 10, 45. Okay, next passing parameter by reference. Okay, if you pass the reference, okay, so it updates the values. Okay, so it just like what, it works as global. Okay, whatever you changes in main program or in function, okay, it get updated every time. Okay, so here initial value is 15, echo initial equal to initial. Okay, it displays 15. Then change parameter. Okay, it jumps here. So here assigned 300. Okay, then display arg equal to 300. Then when it comes back here, okay, when it come back here, initial is equal to, it take 15 only, okay, it not take 300, okay, because so this is a local variable, okay, so this is local variable, this also a local, okay, local to this only, here only 300, but not here, okay, 15 is here only, okay, so if 15 you passed here, but it changed to 300, so it displays what AR is equal to 300, when it come back here, okay, so it take this value only, 15 only, not 300. We just execute, okay, global, okay, function reference. Let's execute. Okay, so here initially it is 15. Initially it is 15. Then I just remove ampersand here. Okay, so initially it is 15 here. Okay, it displays 15, then call the function change parameter, pass 15, so ARG is 15. Now you add 15 plus 300, it become 315, so it displays what ARG equal to 315 here. Then after finishing this function, it come back here, again displays initial equal to initial, initial is 15, so it displays what 15. Okay, so this is what just a normal function. Okay, if you use the reference, if you want to use the reference, just write ampersand here, okay, ampersand ARG, okay, if you use ampersand ARG, okay, so here it get updated, okay, so that that 300 plus 15, so 315 display here also, okay, just execute, save, so here it is 315, okay, because just like what global, okay, so it update here. If you change here, it change here also. Okay, so reference means what? If you change here, it updated here also. If you not use ampersand, if you not use reference, then whatever changes here, it not changing here. Okay, it take the previous value only. Okay, so this is about the reference. How to use the reference? Just put ampersand. Okay, so here initially it is 15, then display initial value, then change parameter, call that function, okay, it changed to 315, okay, 15 plus 300, it become 315. Then if you display initially here, so it displays 15, then just call the function initial, okay, so initially it's 15, then here if you add, it become 315, okay, if you use ampersand, okay, if you use ampersand here, okay, ampersand is used here, okay, if you use ampersand, okay, here it is 315, again in main program also, okay, it displays what 315 only. If you use not ampersand, okay, so it displays old value only, that is 15 only here, okay, here it displays 315, but here it displays 15 only. If you use ampersand, okay, so whatever changes here, you added 300 plus 15, it becomes 315. That changes in main function also, main program also. Okay. Then variable scope with functions. Okay. So the variable limit is to within the function only. Okay. If it comes outside, okay, the value is not changed. Okay. Means here. So here it is 56. Okay, we'll execute and show you. Global. Program is global. Okay. So here, I just remove global here. Okay, so initially test scope, call the function test scope. Okay, so initially count is equal to 56, then call the function test scope. Okay, echo count, so it displays what? 56. Just execute global. Okay, so it displays what? Error. Okay, so echo count, it displays what? 56, but you have not passed any argument here. Okay, so this is the user defined function here. Okay, the count value is not passed as argument here. You not passed any parameters here, so count values don't know the value. Okay, what is the value of count here? It is unknown here, so it displays the error message, undefined variable. Okay, if you make it global, even though if you not pass the argument, okay, so it take this value which is outside the this function. This function is within here only. Okay, if you use global, it take this value. If you not use the global, it displays error message. Okay, I make it global here. Click save and run. So it displays 56. Okay, so same value display here. Okay, if you not make global, so this count value become a unknown. Okay, not defined. Okay, because you not pass the parameters here. Clear, no? Okay. If you not use global, the scope is limited to particular function only. If you use global, that variable you can use anywhere in the program. Okay, outside, inside, or other function. Okay, anywhere you can use global. Clear, no? So this about the functions. Okay, thank you.